meeting minutes to approve. That was our workshop meeting. That was May 14th, 2018. If there isn't any additions or corrections, we need a motion to have those approved.
I'll make a motion to approve the workshop.
Motion on the floor by Dave.
I'll second.
Second by Kyle. All those in favor, please signify by stating aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Carried unanimously. We have our May 14th regular council meeting minutes to approve. If there isn't any additions or corrections, I need to have a motion to approve.
I'll make a motion to approve those minutes.
Motion on the floor by Kyle. I'll second. Second by Dave. All those in favor, please signify by stating aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Carried unanimously. Agenda this evening?
I do not have any additions at this time. If anybody else does.
Do the, those two things you just sent today.
Oh, they were already on there.
Oh, they're on there?
Yep.
Okay. Didn't mention that.
I just sent the supporting documents.
Gotcha.
There are no additions or corrections. We will need a motion to have it approved.
I'll make a motion to approve the agenda as is.
Motion on the floor by Dave.
I'll second.
Second by Kyle. All those in favor, please signify by stating aye.
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 Aye. Opposed? Carried unanimously. First thing we have is building permits. Jim, planning and zoning. Good evening, Jim.
Good evening. We have three permits. One, a concrete permit for Jamie Talbert at 105 Vincent Street North. Just wants to put a 12-foot by 12-foot patio kind of out in the middle of her yard. And there's a problem with that if you want to put it in the middle of your yard, I guess that's good. So they live out, so you got lots of space behind your house. And I was like, well, I'm going to feel south of the area. That's an issue. Then we have a fence permit from Brett Samuels. They live at 209 Robert Street South. Put up a 6-foot privacy fence around behind the house, back about almost 200 feet around. And they're staying 5 feet away from Moser's line on the south side, 10 feet at Curtis Maple's lot on the north side, and then another 10 feet from the back. Yes, all the neighbors, the approval from all four neighbors that got up to it and have signatures in there as well. Then we have another fence permit that just came in today, I guess. It wasn't there yesterday, and we did not have a chance to speak with the lady. And she didn't have any signatures from any of the neighbors. And so we just didn't take any action on it at all. We'll have to contact her and say that you have to have some neighbor signatures. Okay, let me go back to that again. She wants to put a 4-foot high fence, 10 feet from one side, 30 feet from the back, 30 feet from the neighbors. And it's behind a house. She's on Highway 25. Joe and Diane Stangles on the south side, Marvin Hoysel on the back side. And First Avenue would be on the south side. First Avenue would be there. So they'll be on the corner. So that would not be a problem. That's a 4-foot chain link fence.
What was the name of it?
Katie Talbert, T-A-L-B-E-R-T. And so what she's fencing in is a play area. Area, not a recommend that. Yeah, that was my mistake there.
That's okay.
We will need a motion to have the permits approved.
I'll make a motion to approve the permits as read.
On the floor by Dave.
I'll second. Second by Kyle, to approve all those in favor, consider the purpose stated in item five. Aye, opposed? Carried unanimously. Next item we have on the agenda is estimate for updated capital improvement plans. Do we have a record here?
So these next two items are just off the mark, and so I said from the, follow up from what works committee as well. So the first one is, as you recall, back in 2010, we did that, we call it a capital improvements plan. And basically, it was like a plan for when we went through and reviewed the condition of all the streets, mapped on good fares for them, and have qualitative assessment, visual assessment, not a quantitative, for measuring cracks and all that. And then we also went through and prioritized, kind of grouped and prioritized some projects based on the condition of the streets and the needs, you know, by the city, and then did some cost estimating as well. Kind of lumped it all together for, well, what we talked about now is, we've been doing estimates off and on over the years, so we're gonna update estimates, but it's been 8 years since we lived in the streets, so it's a good time to review that. So what's in the scope is to then go with Bob, drive all the streets, come up with new ratings for it, put that on the map, update it, and then also then, just between Bob and I at Public Works, come up with a list, a priority list. Piece together, past estimates. You always have something up, budgeting from the end.
Yeah, it's coming up here within the next couple of years.
Right, we've been talking about it, I think it's always nice with visual people like I am to get very,
It's very, it's been like this for 8 years since.
Yeah.
We've done a number of projects since then, so.
Yeah, right, it's kind of fun to see you knock off, like, but there's others that are coming up with the priority list.
They'll always be like that, though.
Yeah.
So we talked about it, I think at the last council workshop, about Summer Street and some of those projects. That's what this will kind of allow us to do a little bit better.
Well, yeah, I mean, it will, right, exactly.
Kind of gets the estimated cost.
It's a living document, it can change the next day, but at least it's what you're thinking about. Well, have a discussion, a lot of saw to make sure that, things overlap.
So we have actually two of them, we have an estimate update with capital improvement plan, and then an estimate for storm sewer map.
So I did provide yesterday, there's actually a contract for that, so if we're interested in that, but I can jump to the next one.
Sure, go ahead.
So the next one is Public Works related again, and it has to do with mapping and some CAD work. What it is Bob has conveyed that, it would be really nice to have a citywide storm sewer map. You don't have one right now, you have a number of different plans that you can pull from to look at, but you kind of expand on that, but we did some research. I had just asked Bob roughly how many storm structures do you think you have in front of the manholes or catch basins? Put them on the spot, I don't know, 200 maybe. We actually went color along, pulled together different render drawings and aerials and stuff. We're thinking there's closer to 400. And so, the scope, and I've talked about this with Bob, so what I'm proposing here is that we would actually go out with a surveyor and use GPS equipment, like actual survey quality equipment, just be one guy. But we'd actually go out and shoot the top castings of all the structures. We wouldn't, what we call dip up, we wouldn't do popping panels and measuring down and inspect, do a condition analysis, all that kind of stuff, but at least you'd have that. So you'd have an X, Y, Z, that's good, but forever, you can use that actually to build on if you ever want to do GIS mapping or something, so you have that data. But at least for now, though, what we would, the deliverable we would have is we create a map of all the storms through, which basically show like circles and squares where your manholes and catch basins are, connect them with pipes. Step pipe sizing, so we're going to piece together from all the drawings that we have what the different sizes are of the pipes, and then whatever we don't have drawings for, we'll field those manholes and get field measurements from that.
Really nice for future design purposes, if you'll have all that information.
Design, and go for one calls, and if you have any emergencies, like a spill or something. And then even the way that every few years the feds come up with a new storm. Anyway, as you can imagine, going and finding, locating, and shooting in 400 structures, it's a fair amount of effort to do that. So that's our.
This one is 85.
Yeah, the other one is 1,000.
What do you think that was?
10.
You're like one of the fellows.
Well, I definitely think it's time to find out where we are with our road projects, especially if we're doing the North End project, Centennial, where do these other things fall into place? Where's your priority on them? I think we should do that. That's $1,000. I mean, I think that's kind of a, I think,
for sure,
a prerequisite to anything we're going to do. Stormwater sewer one, I'll throw that back at Bob. The importance of knowing what that, can't believe you don't know where they all are, Bob, but.
I don't. I got a call at 6:15 in the morning.
What if Bob wins the lottery?
What if I'm coming to town and I absolutely.
Yes, you could.
So 6:15, I got a call in the morning on a Friday. Me and my wife are leaving for the cities at 7 o'clock. It's emergency located for a water leak. So I got 45 minutes to get that located. He needs to know where the storm sewer went. So I take out the map and I can, look at each individual plan and find it located.
It's a lot of work.
It's frustrating. That's a lot of work. I can just reach my cabinet and grab a map that's
got the whole thing.
Yes. It's got a full.
Would this be computerized?
Yeah.
I mean,
give you
so
a PDF as well.
Call it up on the computer and get an actual location. Kind of drifting off there. If you can't, what if you would have been already gone?
Well,
who else could have done that?
We don't have anything in place for that right now.
Okay.
I only started this storm sewer location last year.
Okay.
We never registered for this.
Okay.
So I need to establish a backup person. Backup person.
Sure.
Can simply look at that map very easily.
With the gray water sewer.
Bob's going like this,
I think it's great. Yeah.
It's likely going to need to get printed
Once we get this big, you should definitely be aware of it.
Small to be able to read it. It's a big area.
Another thing is your emergency. If we do have a tanker spill, that
works
like identify the points of sand in here.
Lock it off, lock it out.
Yeah. Track sand.
Makes sense.
I don't know. I think it's the. One thing I definitely like about it is, once this portion is done and you get all the street catch basin elevations,
don't,
trash inspection on my end, just for example.
And we're not doing a condition assessment either, that's a whole other can of worms, which we certainly can. We have ways of doing that, you know, regular procedure, that spreadsheets and stuff. That's a ton more time, but at least you're not losing anything because you lose, you have to.
I definitely don't see the need, $8,500 just seems like a lot.
It is, don't get me wrong, it's not a problem, it's all new.
Quite honestly, I spent probably 30 hours trying to work together.
Well, we wanna approve these individually?
Yes, please.
Well, I'll make the first one, I mean, kind of all set, I'll make a motion to approve the update on capital improvement plan for $1,000 in ACH.
Motion on the floor by Kyle.
Can I have a second?
Second by Dave, all those in favor, please signify by stating aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed, carried unanimously, and have the estimate for the storm sewer map, mapping.
Yeah, I'll make a motion that we approve that as well.
There's a motion on the floor by Dave to approve.
I'll second.
Second by Kyle, all those in favor, please signify by stating aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed, carried unanimously.
I think you started it.
Yeah.
We got ways to go yet, fellas, right?
Next item we have on the agenda is a exempt permit, and that is for Horizon Health Raffle, September 6th. And I'm thinking, is that their Wacky Hacker?
It's not.
No, that's a raffle.
That's the August.
End of August.
It's supposed to be something else.
And it doesn't state on the permit, so I'm not sure what it's for, but.
Let's see.
Says it'll take place at the Brickyard at that house.
We have to stay there for a little bit. This is for a raffle, is that what it's?
Yeah, they're
For a health, for a raffle.
Yeah, this is a raffle.
I would suspect if it's a raffle with drawing, it's happening at the Brickyard.
Yep.
On September 6th, which they probably wanna get going and selling whatever there's shots.
It's a raffle for a nonprofit.
Motion to have this approved tonight.
Well, it's nice to know what it's for, what it is for, but I'm sure they wanna keep going on it.
Yeah, what type of event they're holding, I mean, what's the occasion, or what they're trying to do, sure, is it a general moneymaker?
I would say must be trying to raise some money.
Or something.
I'll make a motion to approve the raffle, I'm sure it's for a cause.
Motion on the floor by Dave.
I'll second.
Second by Kyle, all those in favor, please signify by stating aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed, carried unanimously. Guys had a chance to take a look at some updates, solid waste committee meeting to the solid waste policy, Nicole, I'll let you just touch on what those are.
Sure, so recently, in August, we've worked on updating the electric policy, so I figured we would review the solid waste policy, see if there are any changes that need to be made. Kind of made it just user-friendly, we've added a table of contents, updated any misspelled words or grammatical errors, kind of updated the process that we're currently doing, and as well as replace the fees that were in there and put C fee schedule, because it's easier to change, update the fee schedule than it is to update the policy, so. Just a few grammatical
yeah, I did my best to read through those, even though some of them were small.
Yeah.
Two of them looks like mostly clerical things.
You were starting, yeah.
I didn't see it's anything too crazy, so I would make a motion that we approve the updated solid waste policy.
Motion on the floor by Kyle to approve the updates.
Second.
Second by Dave, all those in favor, please signify by stating aye.
Aye.
Aye, opposed, carried unanimously.
We'll have that on the website for everybody, as well as the office, if they wanna read it.
Good, good. Dave, I think I'll let you, being on electrical committee, I'll let you talk about the resolution we're looking at in membership to the Northeast and Eastern Minnesota Municipal Power Agency.
Yeah, well, we've been, the electric committee has gone a couple of times now to Grand Rapids for a meeting with a group of other cities. Bob is very, probably more familiar with it than I am, of course, he knows what's going on. But we're trying to organize and create a group so that when we negotiate with Minnesota Power, we have a stronger voice. We put all the kilowatts that all of the different cities use together, we have considerably more bargaining power than what we do alone. There was a group that was formed back in 1978 called the Northeast Minnesota something something, okay? And that's the group that we're looking to join. It includes mostly northeastern Minnesota cities, Staples and Aiken are probably the two closest down into our region. That would be the one that we would join. At this time, there's no fees. We don't know what the fees are. There'll be fees. It depends on how many cities do join. That's what the fees will probably end up being. At this time, they're asking us just to make a resolution authorizing us to go ahead and pursue being joined into that group. We aren't committing any money. We're not committing any confirmation that we're going to stay in.
So anything to add, Bob?
And Minnesota MMUA was part of the group every time, and he represents all municipal utilities in Minnesota. A number of, I can just show you a map. This is the municipal electrics in Minnesota that belong to power agencies. So it's fairly common for municipals to join together as an agency and basically negotiate wholesale contracts, which we're able to purchase from a variety of generators, not just Minnesota Power. So like Dave said, it just gives us better negotiating power.
And we have been approached. A contract was signed with Minnesota Power that extended out to 2024. Several of the cities involved in this group have been approached individually by Minnesota Power, trying to get them to extend their contract and trying to give them a better deal. We've also been approached, and we were really considering what they were offering us because we were also trying to obtain some additional territory that we currently don't have within the city limits. They were willing to give us that, and it looked like a fairly reasonable deal. And after a couple of meetings with the people in the group, we're starting to realize that maybe that deal wasn't as great as it could be. So we're thinking that we can, even saving a cent off a kilowatt or 5 cents off a kilowatt is huge, for the different price we get. So I think we need to stay in this group, pursue this group, and see what it can do for us.
Well, there's strength in numbers.
Strength in numbers, yeah.
Yeah, it definitely helps your negotiating ability. There's no doubt about it. We haven't ever, even though we've been up to a lot of meetings in Grand Rapids and things of that nature, will we ever formally part of an organization or about that?
No, but the group did negotiate collectively in
2015.
2015, it was a group effort. There was 15.
It was good.
It was
a very good thing.
And now it's more of a one-on-one with Minnesota Power and these individual principles. And to me, that's.
And Minnesota Power, not to put them out to be the bad guy, but they figured out that they have a little better bargaining chip dealing with cities individually. Because they can hit the city's individual problems and try to crack it. And our issue is we'd like more territory. We don't have everything in the city with Minnesota Power.
Is what else? I know that actually I'm on one of the strips that we have currently. Is that the only one or is there more?
There's more. Park Avenue is the other one.
So we're locked in with Minnesota Power till 2024?
Correct.
Yes, and we have to give them 3-year notice that we're not extending the contract, so we have to by 2021.
We have to decide.
We have to decide.
So this group, it's possible you could get power from someone else?
Very possible, because there's different agency options where we can actually purchase wind, solar, coal, we can diversify. There's generators all over the place, so, and now is really a good time to lock in some of these long-term contracts and moving to all of the agencies that we've been talking to.
Agencies do a lot of research on and just bring that to us, that's a lot of good information.
Yeah, that's the group you just mentioned as well. Give us what they're going to be doing.
Compass was the agency that was,
yeah,
had our last.
They would be the group that would try to spearhead this and be doing a lot of good research for us.
That's a few steps ahead of where we're at now.
Yeah.
First step is to make this one.
It kind of is, yeah. Well, we were
the
one apartment. The group was there in 1978, and they kind of disintegrated. They didn't do a lot because there really wasn't a need to for a while. And now there's a call for it again.
Sure.
Well, compared to what we were paying and the way things really were structured and working prior to entering into the last agreement,
in our hope and desire is actually going to be better.
Yeah.
Well, that'd be awesome. And Minnesota Power is a great asset. They're a great big brother. We need them.
Oh, absolutely.
Right to do our work.
Right.
Yes.
Yeah. And so
yes.
We don't, at the end of the day, we'll shoot with them again.
Yeah. Yeah.
So,
yeah.
Yeah. All options that we can.
For now, let's move forward with the resolution. We can see if everybody's comfortable with it. If you want, Dave,
okay, resolution 053-02018-01. Whereas the city of Pierce is authorized either by the laws of the state of Minnesota or by its city charter adopted pursuant thereto engage in the local distribution and sale of electric energy. Whereas city has reviewed the agency agreement dated as of December 1st, 1978, and relating to the creation of the Minnesota, or excuse me, to the creation of the Northeastern Minnesota Municipal Power Agency, the agency. For the purpose of exercising certain rights and powers as a member of the agency in accordance with the Minnesota Statutes, section 453-51 through 453-62, inclusive of the Act, and reviewed all other matters deemed relevant by the city. Whereas the City Council of the City of Pierce has determined that it is the best interest of city and its electric ratepayers to become a member of the agency in accordance with Section 9A of the Agency Agreement. Now, therefore, be it resolved by the City Council of the City of Pierce, Section 1, the City agrees to be bound by all the provisions of the Agency Agreement and by the law and bylaws of the Agency. Section 2, the city authorizes Robert O'Krempa to make a formal request that city become a member of the agency and to undertake any and all actions required to effectuate the intent of this resolution, including payment of an amount equal to a share of the cost and expenses incurred by the agency as may be reasonably designated by the agency. Section 3, the following individuals are designated to serve as a representative and alternative representative of the city in accordance with Section 9A(1) of the agency agreement and shall be each purported power and authority to serve in the capacity on behalf of the city in any matter regarding the agency. The name of the representatives are Bob O'Krempa and the alternate representative is Nicole Sewell.
Thanks, Dave. Heard the reading of the resolution. Is there any questions or concerns regarding the resolution?
I'm not
Club, shelter donation, June 4th, and that's for Mayor's Thompson and Olson. We'll be hosting the commercial club meeting. And they are requesting, obviously, a shelter down at the park to host that, so it'd be kind of nice if we could help out the commercial club and donate that shelter.
I'll make a motion that we donate the North Shelter to the commercial club for their June 4th meeting.
There is a motion on the floor by Dave to approve.
Shall I abstain?
No.
I'm actually.
You get a second?
I'll second it.
All those in favor?
Say aye.
By stating aye.
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 Opposed?
Carried unanimously. Good luck with the commercial club meeting.
Yeah, thank you guys.
We have some department reports. Bobby Oak.
He's been at the court house since May 15th. She's taking very well the position. She's very ambitious. Has a lot of good ideas. Right now, she's just trying to get her where we're at and training on the floor we have. She's making very good progress and she's a very good employee.
Do we have the software stuff in place yet, Nicole, with that, or that's still coming?
It's in place. We're just waiting on training. The plan is to do it tomorrow if everything goes right. Depending on Gary, but we're thinking, hoping to have it up by June 1st. If that doesn't work, well, we do it July 1st. But it's down there. It's ready to go. Just making sure we've got everybody trained.
Sure.
One thing on the streets I'd like to look for approval is spray and dredging patching. That aren't quite so bad, but it's a nice thin layer patch. We can do 7 tons of material. They just do a day rate of 3250, 3250 for paving resources. So the patching that I have, I can't apply it that thin and it doesn't pull up that well, so it's
sure. Is that something you want to do?
Construction in town, you see on Edward Street, there's CenturyLink is putting a fiber through town. That was approved last year. Right-of-way permit, so they're basically going from CenturyLink's office. Down Edward Street, Second Avenue North. So that'll be going for about 3 weeks. There's going to be a lot of restoration. I've been looking at a postponer for installing our street signs. This is what we currently use. Well, it's on the front of the tractor. This big 400-pound piece of metal raises up and the signs are on. It's not going to save. What I'd like to go to is just a handheld. It's a low gas, 4-stroke pump engine. Just acts as a jackhammer. Got an estimate for that. $2,812. I saw this on KBIT and I exactly like this one for $3,000. So we can sell it on our GovBIT website. We should be able to get close to that
Was the quote
Water.
Water.
fantastic. Last day of school for peers was today, so schools are going to be empty starting tomorrow. Graduation went very well Friday night with no pranks being pulled on the school district. Next month, the whole department's going to be gone for 2 days. We're attending an active shooter class to bring in new policy procedures to our schools, peers, middle, whatever it might be, the way the nation's, you know, advancing the system. So we will be attending that with members of the school district. I reached out to two organizations requesting funding for updating some of our active equipment that we need in the squad cars. And Williams' next council meetings, I'll present who the organizations are. One is LE, some of the other local, but they both, they wanted us each $1,000. I'll show them work on some of this updating equipment, so it's not going to be at the city's dime. So when I get that, we'll present that to council when they come to present the check or the funding to the city.
Yeah.
Other than that, I have not been able to go to school. Kel was doing a great job. They're very busy, but the school I know is actually still out for us. Any questions for me? That's cool, around 50. The only thing I can think of, she's
getting out her skipping knees.
Thanks, Eric.
Thanks, Eric. Nicole?
I don't have much to hide there because I'm going to have this stuff catching up on some of my to-dos. Just to go back to the clubhouse applications, if you guys are all right, we will be posting on three sites like Facebook, our website, and the lead, just to take in any applications that come in.
Oh, that's cool.
So Jamie's kind of strapped for some help, so anybody that can get this kind of helpful, so if you guys are all right.
So we are looking at, clubhouse, and we'd like to help to pull it.
Currently, there's some staff that can't put in very many hours.
Sure.
So it'd be nice to give her what she needs, so she can effectively manage.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
And the more availability she's got to reach out to people, the better.
Yeah.
Especially covering weekends.
So if anybody is out there is aware of anybody who is looking for some part-time work, we are looking to hire them at the clubhouse, so don't be shy. You can download our application online, send it back in online if you'd like, or take and drop it off. Find out a little bit more about the position and stuff, talk to Nicole or look up Bobby.
Amy's
or
nice.
Amy, yeah.
She's got another clubhouse too.
Oh, okay. Awesome. So you can stop right down there and grab one as well. That's all.
Other than that, that's all I really got right now.
Thanks, Nicole. Treasurer's report.
Checkbook balance with the statement on April 30th was $888,195.54.
Anything else you got, Linda? Motion to approve the treasurer's report.
I'll make a motion to approve the treasurer's report.
Motion on the floor, that be?
I'll second.
Second by Kyle, all those in favor, please signify by stating aye.
Aye.
Aye, opposed. Carried unanimously. We have some bills to pay.
I would make a motion as soon as my screen updates.
Yeah, absolutely.
Bills are $136,828.
I got it here now too. I'll make a motion to pay the bills at the tune of $136,828.81.
Motion on the floor by Kyle.
And I'll second that.
Second by Dave, all those in favor, please signify by stating aye.
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 Opposed? Carried unanimously. Thank you, Linda. Anybody else have any